welcome back. Today I am doing my top 5 nude lipsticks. This was very, very hard to do because I actually had about 10 and I really had to think about and pare it down. I definitely have a lot of lipstick favorites, so I really just narrowed it down to 5 and then a couple of honorable mentions. I will mention a few lip liners that I do like to use with some of these lipsticks, so I will include that in this video as well. In this video, I will be doing with my friend Autumn 08. I'm doing this with Autumn, and I will link her channel below, and I think it's good just to get a different idea of what nudes look good on different people. She is a little bit lighter skinned than I am. I'm about an NC25 in the dead of winter, and about NC30 most of the year. So I think that this would be a good video to kind of compare what nudes tend to look a little bit more complimentary, or what we tend to gravitate towards, you know, depending on our skin tone, because I can't wear like those super duper plain nudes that make you look dead. So I tend to prefer something a little bit darker. So I'm gonna go ahead, and I actually have some that are most drugstore, and some higher end. Anyhow, the first color that I have here is called Blankety. This is probably one of my first, no, this is not my first nude, but I tend to wear this more in the fall and the winter because it is more of like a, kind of like a cooler tone nude for me. And it's more like on the pinky beige side. So I'm actually gonna swatch these here, and I'm gonna try to be really good about these here. So again, this is Blankety. So that's Blankety right there. And so it's more like a pinky beige. I really like how this looks on my lips because it doesn't make me look dead. I feel like it just really stands out. It wears well. It looks like I'm wearing something. It looks like my lips, but better. And I really enjoy wearing colors like that. And again, I would wear more towards the fall and winter. The next color that I have, and I'm actually gonna stick with things that I would wear more in the winter and then go towards like the spring and summer. But this is by Rimmel, and this is number 14. It is the one that I am wearing right now. I tend to wear this more in the fall and the winter as well. I kind of mix it up. I have worn this in the spring and summer, but I feel that it is a little bit on the darker side, and I just prefer to wear something a little bit brighter or lighter in the spring and summer. Again, this is number 14. I really love the formula of the Rimmel lipsticks that come in this black tube. These are the Kate Moss lipsticks. They have Kate's name here. And they just really feel nice on the lips. They're kind of like a semi-matte on the lips. They're not drying at all. They go on very smoothly, and they wear very, very nicely. And actually, those two are very similar. I didn't realize that. We can call this almost a dupe video. So I'm actually looking at them in the camera. They look almost exactly the same. I'm just looking in the mirror here, and I would say that it's very hard to tell, but this Rimmel number 14 has a slightly peachier tone, whereas the Blankety has more of a rosier tone. So there is a slight difference, but if you're one of those people that don't really care for the slight differences, this would actually be a great dupe for Blankety. The next color that I have is also by Rimmel, and this one is in the same packaging. This is 08. They unfortunately don't have names. I prefer names. I just feel like I can remember them better, but this is 08. They have the numbering system here. And this is another nude, but I would say it's kind of like a darker nude. I'm just gonna go ahead and swatch that here. It's almost like a rosy nude. So that's 08. I would say that it looks a little bit lighter when I wear this on my lips, and it's something that, again, I wear more often in the fall and the winter time, and not wear it so much during the spring and summer. But again, it's one of my favorite nudes to wear because I feel like in the winter I'm already looking so pale that if I wear something a little bit lighter, I just look totally dead. This is another one that I would wear more in the winter time, kind of like winter spring. And this is a Dior Addict Extreme lipstick. I actually got this at the end of last year or beginning of last year. I think it was like at the beginning of last year. I can't remember. Of this year, I'm sorry. And this is number 316, Incognito. It's my only Dior, like, super high-end lipstick. It's probably the lipstick that I've spent the most money on, even though I actually did have a gift card. But it is, it's feels so awesome on the lips. It's really nice. It's more of a kind of like mauve-y nude, and I really love this. It just, it's very easy. It's like you don't have to think about it. You just, it goes with very, you know, a lot of looks. If you just want to look really plain kind of nude, not their makeup, and you throw this on, it doesn't look like you're super overdone, and it's just really easy. It feels great on the lips. I really love these lipsticks, and I was kind of mad when I tried it because I actually really, really enjoy it. I'm going to go ahead and swatch this one actually on this side. So as you can see, I tend to, you know, stick to the similar colors. But this, I would say, goes a little bit lighter than those other ones do. This is a lighter nude right here. And actually, when I was trying to pick some of my lipsticks and I swatched this one and I was trying to decide between this one and MAC's Midi Mauve, which I really, really love. This was very similar to Midi Mauve. This one's just a little bit glossier, and Midi Mauve is slightly darker than this one. But they're very, very similar in tone. So there you go. Okay, I am gonna have to cheat. I really have to cheat because I really didn't realize that I have these favorites. I have to cheat. I'm sorry, Autumn. The next one that I have is Kinda Sexy by MAC. And this one I bought after I saw Flower Bomb 31 talk about this, and I fell in love with it when I tried it on. It is absolutely beautiful. And this one I wear more towards the spring and summer. You know, you don't have to wear these things only in the spring and summer, but I just tend to, kind of gravitate more towards that time. I could definitely wear this in the fall, depending on the makeup look that I'm wearing, but it is more of like a peachy nude, and it is just absolutely beautiful. And again, the name is perfect. It definitely makes you look sexy. It's such a beautiful lipstick on. And this is part of the MAC formula from MAC. Next to Incognito, which is a little bit lighter mauve. So that's kind of sexy. I would say that it doesn't necessarily go on that dark, but it is definitely very pigmented. So again, more of a peachy nude. Excuse the nasaliness, I'm a little sick. So that was five. That was five lipsticks, and I'm gonna do six and then two honorable mentions. I'm sorry, I just had to. I cannot leave this lipstick out because when I discovered it, I fell in love. I bought this one last year. It is also from MAC. This one is a very beloved lipstick by a lot of people here on YouTube, and this one is Peach Blossom. It is a cream sheen, and I tend to really gravitate more towards this in the spring and summer. And this is more of like a lighter peach, kind of like a lighter peach nude. And again, that's Peach Blossom. So I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is my extra. That's six. Favorite nudes. And then I have two honorable mentions. And the reason that I'm gonna make them honorable mentions is because they are actually pretty new to me. And I did get them this past summer, or at the end of the summer. The first one that I'm going to mention is Revlon's Honey Bear. This is part of their Shine collection. It's kind of like their, I would say it's almost like the Lusters from MAC, which tend to be a little bit more glossy and a little bit more sheer. And this is kind of like a light brown beige. I really like how this looks on the lips. You do have to be careful. I would say I tend to wear a little bit of a lip liner with this because you can look a little bit dead if you're not careful. I'm actually gonna swatch this here on this side since I have space. So this is Honey Bear. And again, it is way more sheer, and again, you see how I have to go over with that. But it is very, very pretty. Unfortunately, this one I did not find at my Target. I have to go to like a Harman's Pharmacy to find this one, and they did have it, but Revlon lipsticks are one of my favorites from the drugstore. The next honorable mention that I have as a nude is this Rimmel Moisture Renew that I acquired recently, and this one is in Notting Hill Nude. This one really surprised me because I was thinking that I would look super dead with this lipstick, and it leans more of like a kind of like a peachy nude, I would say. And I think we're finding more dupes. I didn't realize that. This is Notting Hill Nude. It looks very similar to Peach Blossom. So I'm going to have to swatch those next to each other. One second. No, they are not the same. So these are not the same. I actually just swatched Peach Blossom from MAC right here. It's definitely more of a peachy pink, whereas Notting Hill Nude is more of a beigey peach. I would say it's more beige peach than the other colors. So those are my favorite nudes. I'm gonna go over these colors one more time for you. So I'm just gonna show you what the swatches are, and we're gonna go ahead and start from this side. This is Rimmel's Moisture Renew in Notting Hill Nude. This is Revlon's Honey Bear. This is Rimmel 08. This is Rimmel 14. This is MAC's Blankety. This is Dior's Incognito. MAC Kinda Sexy. And MAC Peach Blossom. So those are my top favorite nudes. There were six favorites, two honorable mentions. I kinda cheated. I actually like watching videos when people actually cheat because I like having more options, so I'm sure you guys don't mind. So that is all. I definitely have other nudes that I really love, and I hated not mentioning them, but I had to like think of the ones that I favorited over time. And obviously this might change. This is not like not ever changing because my favorites shift all the time. Please tell me below what your favorite nude is. I would love to know, and give me suggestions if you have any favorites. Please make sure to go and check out Autumn's channel. I will link her video down below. If you have any questions, comments, or requests, please leave them down below, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.